Hello one and all, my name is Rio and welcome to another matchday vlog. Today Chester FC host Blyth Spartans at home, where we look to put our recent defensive issues behind us. So hopefully we have worked on a few set pieces in training over the past few days, because last Saturday we were toothless defensively. Also, our strikers do need to step up today, because in three of our last five games we have failed to hit the target at Royston Town, Leamington and Gateshead last Tuesday. So today our strikers do need to be firing on all cylinders. So of course I do hope you enjoyed today's video. If so, please like, subscribe and comment down your score forecast and your thoughts of the game below. So let's get into today's video right now. Enjoy. We simply cannot afford to be turning up to today's game thinking that it will be a walk in the park or a 4 or 5 nil win, because that will simply not happen today. Because you just have to look at the Curzon Ashton home game a few months ago back in December, where we were expecting it to be an easy win, and guess what happened? Curzon beat us in our own backyard. So we do need to play our strongest team today to avoid a similar result, because Blyth are a similar team to Curzon Ashton. Also, last weekend we recorded our first back-to-back defeat of the entire season, so it will be quite interesting to see how we do respond today, because Blyth are fighting for their lives, so it won't be an easy game today, and they will have a lot of fire in their body after a few weeks ago where they beat fellow relegation rivals Curzon Ashton at home. So today's game will by no means be easy. So our last match was last Saturday, as we lost 4-2 away at York City. So my word, it was an absolute horror show defensively, because all four goals we conceded were terrible schoolboy defending. So today we need to do loads better, and as I said before, hopefully we have worked on a few things on the training field, otherwise Blyth could punish us. So the first half was quite lively and defensive. However, it was York City who made it 1-0, as it was former Chester City player Sean Newton who headed in from a corner to make it 1-0. However, a few moments later, we responded in fantastic fashion, as Jamie Morgan scored an excellent solo goal for us to make it 1-1. So he ran with the ball on the edge of the area, and he fired into the far left-hand corner to put us back in the game. Things got from bad to worse though, as York City retook the lead once again to make it 2-1. So it was a comical goal to concede, because we headed the ball about five times, it went nowhere, and all Kieran Green had to do was head home into the far left hand corner. It was a powerful header to make it 2-1 to York City. York City had the ball in the net once again a few moments later, but thankfully Jordan Burrow was disallowed for offside. However, before half-time, York City got the third goal to make it 3-1, as debutant Kurt Willoughby scored at the back post to get a third goal for York. Meanwhile, the second half was less eventful, but we still had a massive mountain to climb, and it was too little too late. However, in the first 10 minutes of the half, George Glendon gave us a fighting chance for us to make it 3-2, as the Joel Taylor cross went in, and he scored a really good powerful goal into the far left hand corner to give us a fighting chance of a potential comeback. It all went pear shaped once again though, because at the other end, York City made it 4-2, so it was a great delivery by Sean Newton to be involved in his second goal of the game, and Kurt Willoughby scored his second of the game to head across the face of goal. Things got even worse for us, as Jamie Morgan got sent off for us, as he picked us up his second yellow card of the game, to return from hero to zero within a few minutes, because in the first half he scored a really good goal, but in the second half it was one to forget for him. So sadly there was no way back for us. So you can watch all six goals of the York game in my matchday preview, which was out before midnight yesterday, so head over if you wish. When the day is dawning on a Blyth Spartans will be visiting from Northumberland, having had an abysmal season so far, because last season Blyth finished in the playoff places, which was an impressive season for them. However, a number of their key players and also former manager Alan Armstrong left in the summer to sign for fellow clubs such as Darlington and York City, such as Dan Maguire, for example. So, Blyth have spent the majority of this season in the relegation zone and they aren't doing well whatsoever. So, back in June, so a few months ago, back in the summer, former Bury, Blackpool, Birmingham City and Huddersfield Town boss Lee Clark was appointed as Blyth's new manager. However, despite his wealth of EFL experience, even he hasn't managed to help Blyth out so far, who were dealt another massive blow a few weeks ago back in January, as their best player, Callum Roberts, signed for National League club Notts County. So Blyth are in massive turmoil as we speak, and they are in a massive relegation battle alongside Gloucester City, who are in free fall as we speak. So Blyth only sits 3 points below Gloucester. So if Blyth do get their act together, then maybe they could stay up. However, they are going to be up against it and they will have to win a lot of matches to avoid a return to Step 7. Sunday morning, how I long to be there. We have played against Blyth Spartans 3 times before, with our last match being on October the 19th, 2019, which was a 2-2 away draw at Croft Park. So it was quite an entertaining, action-packed game, just like it was last week at York City. And in the second half in particular, we were all over Blyth. However, we just weren't clinical enough in the final third. So today, we need to be loads better in the final third. So, you can watch all of the goals from Croft Park in my matchday preview, which was out yesterday. So head over to that one if you haven't already. With Marie, who's waiting for me there. My score forecast for today's game is Chester FC 3, Blyth Spartans 1. So for Chester, I think Akwasi Asante, George Glendon and Gary Roberts will score for us. And for Blyth, I think Scott Fenwick will score for them today. So I did say earlier on in today's video that the goals have dried up in recent matches. So today, our strikers do need to step up and I do think it will be quite a routine win for us today. Where I hang my hat. As ever, I will be going to the 1885 Arena today, so stay tuned for my matchday vlog, which will be coming up right now. So, of course, I do hope you enjoyed today's video. If so, please like, subscribe and comment down your thoughts of the game below. So it is a massive home game today. Cannot wait. Come on, City! Ain't us half as pretty. It's where my baby's at. Is this the way to Amarillo? Every night I've been hugging my pillow, dreaming dreams of... I have now arrived at the 1885 Arena, ready for today's game. So we seriously do need a win today because we have recorded back-to-back defeats for the first time this season at Gateshead and York away. So our strikers do need to step up now because in 3 of our last 5 games we have recorded blanks at Royston, Leamington and of course Gateshead a few days ago. So today our strikers such as Asante, Dudley or maybe even Matty Hughes need to get back in and amongst the goals today. So it's a big game and Blyth will be fighting for their lives. So it should be a good game today between sides who do need the points for different reasons. So looking forward to it now. Come on, you Blues. Coming to see her just beyond the high.
Come on, City!
Here is your Chester FC squad for today's game. We are in a 4-4-2 formation, so in goal is number 1 Russ Griffiths, in defence is 2 Kevin Roberts, 5 James Jones, 6 Simon Grand and 3 Joel Taylor. In midfield is 7 John Johnston, 4 Captain Scott Burton, 8 George Glendon and 11 Brad Jackson, and up front is 9 Akwasi Asante and 10 Matty Hughes. On the substitutes bench is 12 Gary Roberts, 14 Gary Stopforth, 15 Matty Waters, 16 Anthony Dudley and 17 Alton Nguitala. And here is your Blyth Spartan squad for today's game. Enjoy the vlog. Come on, you Blues.
I am City! City, I am!
George! Oh! Come on, City! Corner ball! Shot by George Glendon must deflect it for a corner. So Joel Taylor is going to take it on the left-hand side. He's got it all! And the Blyth keeper punches it out to Taylor again. And he's got it again. Another cross by him to Hughes. Go on! Oh! Back heel by Matty Hughes went out wide. Oh! Unlucky Brad! Shout by Brad Jackson went miles over from about 25 yards out. Go on, Jacko! Oh! Unlucky Jacko again! Another chance by Brad Jackson went wide. One! Oh! Unlucky Asante! Good start by us here! Come on, City! Decent start by us here, another chance by us by Asante. Fourthly, decent save out of the Blyth goalie, so we have another corner here. It's got it by Taylor. Oh! And the Blyth keeper punched it out again. I think it's a bit dodgy, that Blyth goalie. He's punched it out twice now. I have been saying how poor the Blyth goalie has been, and once again he's punched the ball out for our third corner of the game, so we have it on the right hand side this time. It's gone in. Oh, and he's punched it again to Asante now. Follow it up. Yeah! Go on! Go on! Get in there! Chester FC 1, Blyth Spartans 0. Fantastic start by Chester. 15 minutes in, already 1-0. So again, Akwasi Asante once again. The Blyth goalie punched it out, and Asante followed it up into the roof of the net to make it 1-0. Great start here. Go on, Joel! Oh! Come on, hit it! Oh! Shot by Brad Jackson was blocked. Go on, Jacko! Oh! Come on, City! Come on, City! Another chance by Jacko went over.
You're right
up
there, Dave.
Go on now, Hughesy, hit it! Oh! Another corner here. Come on, City! Matty Hughes did really well to cut inside, and his shot was deflected. gone in by George Glendon and Blythe headed away at the near post. Quasi Asante was unlucky to not have got enough after another shot by him was deflected, so Joel Taylor is going to take our corner now on the left once again. So it's gone in to the back. Oh! I thought it went in for a moment. Then Blythe Gawley tipped it onto the roof of the net for another corner. So it is going to be taken by George Glendon on the right hand side again. It's gone in! Oh! Towards Kev Roberts, but Blythe head away again.
Come on, City!
Half time, Chester FC 1, Blythe Spartans 0. So we have been all over Blythe so far in the first half, with a Kwasi Asante score being the difference between both sides. So it was a corner which went in, the Blythe goalie flapped at it, and Asante scored the rebound into the roof of the net to make it 1-0. So the Blythe keeper has been terrible today. He hasn't caught a single cross so far, so we do need to take advantage now. So we think we do need to get a few more goals now to kill the game off, because Blythe are quite a poor team. However, they are going forward in the final third, so we do need to try and get another goal or two to see the game off now. So hopefully the second half will be more of the same. Come on, you Blues.
City! Come on, City! Come on, City!
Good win. A Blythe Spartans player has just been sent off. There was a really, really poor late tackle, so thankfully the ref gave him a straight red card. Oh, come on, that's it! Oh! Second goal! Cross went in towards Asante, but Blythe clear.
Come on, City! Come on, City!
Oh, come on now! Come on, JJ! Oh! John Johnson was so close to getting his first ever Chester goal. Shot by him went just across the face of goal and wide for a corner. So it's gone in by Joel Taylor, and the Blythe keeper punches. Come on, JJ now! Oh! JJ so close again. Oh! And the follow-up is pushed out wide. Come on, City!
Come on, City! Come on, City!
So Blythe headed out the initial shot by JJ, and the follow-up by, I think it was George Glendon, was pushed out by the Blythe goalie for another corner. So the corner's been taken short to JJ. Bit of a lapsy-daisy follow-up.
Nice to see you,
look today. You want to? Hey, listen, it's fine, Dave.
Take your piss out.
Oh, yeah! Go on, get in! That shall do it now, 2-0.
Go on!
Chester FC 2, Blythe Spartans 0. James Jones has scored another header like he did at Guiseley. So the corner by Joel Taylor went in, and James Jones headed home. So 2-0 now, that should do it. We have another corner now, so oh. Go on now! Oh! Oh! Don't know what happened there. We tried to play the ball in, but Blythe scrambled this away. Manchester FC 2 Blyth Sports and Swansea. Blyth do have a goal back. It did eventually go in thanks to the wind. There were a few chances for Blyth in the build-up. We tried to clear away, but Blyth got the rebound in. So 2-1 now. We need to try and do our best to see the game out. Otherwise, it could be a comeback. Oh! Nearly 3-1. Free kick by George Glendon went in. The Blyth goalie flapped at it. Almost went past him.
Come on, City! Come on, City! Come on, City!
Full time, Chester FC 2, Blyth Spartans 1. So we had to do it the hard way, but a win is a win. So thankfully, we are back on track now. More reaction shortly. Chester FC 2, Blyth Spartans 1. So we had to do it the hard way, but overall we were full value for our win, even though we could have easily made things easier for ourselves by killing it off at an earlier stage. Thankfully, our opponents were really poor today, because on another afternoon, a better team could have punished us for some of the lazy mistakes we made. The swirling conditions certainly didn't help, as the second half in particular was really stop-start. Despite it not being the best of games, the most important thing is that we got all 3 points, which is all that matters, as we have managed to stop the rot. Blyth Spartans were a toothless team, as they truly showed just why they are near the bottom. Also, they were quite a dirty outfit too, because they had a reputation of pushing our players over, and their centre-half was all over Akwasi Asante for the entire game. Blyth reminded me a bit like Leamington back in September, but thankfully, unlike that 3-3 game, we managed to get the job done this time and get all 3 valuable points. Our first half display was really dominant, as we maintained the bulk of possession, and to be fair, we should have found the net a few more times. We were prone to the odd misplaced pass, but compared to recent matches, we've shown signs of encouragement. Inside just 2 minutes, George Glendon went very close to make it 1-0 as a deflected hit went over, which eventually saw Brad Jackson's attempt go wide from the following corner. We maintained our quick start to proceedings, as an Akwasi Asante header was parried out by Zach Hemming following a Brad Jackson strike that sailed past the post. On the 12th minute mark, the inevitable happened, as Akwasi Asante made it 1-0 to us. So Hemming was really dodgy for Blyth today, and for the opener, he made another really poor mistake by flapping at the corner, which landed to Asante, who fired into the roof of the net to make it 1-0. At the other end, Robbie Dale glanced just wide for Blyth to give us a slight scare, whilst Brad Jackson blazed over just a few moments later, after dribbling past a number of Blyth defenders. Blyth defenders were called into action once again to prevent a second goal from going in, as they blocked a Matty Hughes shot at the last second. After that, Asante wasn't too far away from getting a second goal, as a strong hit by him was deflected out for another corner. All in all, it was a comfortable display for us, which saw us go into half-time with a deserved lead. The second half wasn't as clinical from us, because we didn't work as hard as we did in the first, which invited Blyth Spartans back into the game. To their credit, they made us run for our money, as they started off as the brighter side in the half to carry it on until the final whistle. We were just a bit more sloppy in our play, as we often ran into dead ends, lacked support, and also whenever we had the ball, we made a couple of misplaced passes too.
Russ Griffiths was called into action straight away as he had to palm away a goal-bound header from a corner. However, our chances of recording a much-needed win increased after the 50th minute mark as Shane Blaney got sent off for Blythe Spartans on his debut thanks to a really late tackle on George Glendon, I think it was. Due to the windy weather picking up, the football on offer became more direct, which reduced the number of chances being created. John Johnson went very close to netting his first goal though, as he struck a shot centimetres wide, whilst both him and George Glendon saw chances blocked from a corner. Moments later though, we got the killer second, as James Jones headed home from a beauty of a Joel Taylor corner to make it 2-0 to us. Towards the conclusion of the encounter, Blythe Spartans pulled a goal back to make it 2-1 as Ollie Scott bundled home from a goalmouth scramble. Zach Hemming was then in the way of us confirming our first win of the month as he pulled off a great save to deny Anthony Dudley, whilst Dud saw another chance saved in injury time, this time a powerful volley. Despite a late onslaught from our opponents, two goals was enough to see us get over the line. On the whole, we performed better this afternoon with not many of our team putting in bad cameos, so I will go for James Jones as being my man of the match for today as he stood up to the plate really well. Because with Danny Livesey unable to play, Jonah was always going to be up against it, but he stepped into Livesey's shoes with no issues. He was dominant in the air and topped it off with a second headed goal in as many months as he scored the winning goal at Guiseley back in January. Also, Joel Taylor was much better this afternoon as he has blew hot and cold lately. However, he was back to his old best today on the left hand side as he ran up and down the pitch with the ball regularly and got the crosses in, and he even bagged an assist for Jones's goal as it was a fantastic corner by Joel Taylor. Meanwhile, Brez Jackson was decent in some patches as well because his pacey runs were much more effective. However, I'm not too sure on Scott Burton though, because whenever I saw him, he backed away with the odd tackle and gave the ball away too many times as well. So that's just my opinion though, because other people do think he was their man of the match, so it is just my opinion. Also, John Johnson was up and down as he struggled to break through, and he certainly put the effort and the hard work in, but he often ran into dead ends and he struggled to break through as well, so we're not too sure on John Johnston either. So it is early days though, and once he does gel into our team, I am sure he will perform a lot more consistently. Our next match is on Saturday as we play Alfreton Town away. So, luckily enough for us, Danny Elliott will be ineligible to play, which is a big boost for us as he has found the net 5 times in 3 games during his loan spell at Alfreton so far. In my opinion, we simply have to win at Alfreton because they are in mid-table and we simply cannot afford to make any more slip-ups because we got a big win today, and also with Boston United pulling off an unexpected result against York City, it is so important we won today, otherwise there would be a hefty gap between us and third place. So we can breathe a little bit more lightly now, but we have a series of tough games coming up where we will have to play better than we did today, because the stronger teams would have sussed us out if we played them today. Of course, I will be going to Alfreton, so look out for a matchday preview, which will be out on Friday, and on Saturday I will do a vlog of the game as well. So, of course, I do hope you enjoyed today's matchday vlog. If so, please like, subscribe, and comment down your thoughts of the game below. So a massive, much-needed win today. Get in there, and thankfully we have stopped our losing run. So see you at Alfreton. What a win! Come on, you Blues. Shut up.